Welcome to Assistant on Air, where we have conversations with people that build for Google Assistant. I'm Jessica, and I'll be your host today. Today, we'll be chatting with Steve, who's a Google developer expert for Google Assistant. Welcome, Steve.
Hey, Jessica.
So tell me, Steve, what do you do on your day job?
So I am a teacher, basically. So I lecture students at the University College London on various things in data science and various different classes that are kind of computing based.
Oh, that's awesome. So how did you get interested in the voice space?
So it's a really interesting story. I used to do a lot of research back in the day in the University of Glasgow on human-computer interaction.
Oh.
And back in the day, we were using different devices, different multimodalities, and experimenting how we can kind of bring things together and, you know, enhance people's day-to-day kind of interactions with computers.
Yeah.
And so when the assistant came along, it was like, wow, I wish we had this like 10 years ago, because this would have been amazing. And
a lot easier.
And literally, so it's bringing that old kind of research interest back into my day job. So yeah, so it's a way for me to get to play with cool toys and cool things.
That's awesome. And I heard that you built a really cool toy for your students.
Yes.
Called Scavenger Hunt, right?
Yes, yes. So
yeah, tell me about that.
So this was based on the idea what we had for new students coming into the university in our department. So they could basically, we'd set up one day where they would put them in teams of four, and we'd basically go and explore the city, and they would have to go and take photos of buildings and go to various places around London, and then all come back and we'd give them points, and it was like a kind of bonding experience for the students.
Nice.
And so I had this idea, I was like, how could we expand on this and make it more kind of techie and more geeky? Because, you know, we were doing it by hand and we had all these checklists.
Oh,
so
no,
we were
no.
basically, yeah, yeah, exactly. It's like, you know, we were thinking about the teacher and we just like, whoa, this. So it's like, how can we bring technology into this to kind of live how we, you know, what we're teaching
exactly.
at university. So had this idea, so we built this, you know, action where, you know, it would automate everything and we can basically set the students out and actually so the idea from that grew from how do we actually, rather than just being a one day event, how do we actually build a kind of a longer experience
on
this?
Wow. So, yeah. Oh, that's so cool. So from what's the experience from the student's point of view? So
okay.
what do they do?
Okay, so they wake up in the morning and they talk to the action, and they'll be given like four things they need to find in the day. So that could be go to a phone box, or go to the Tower of London, or go to, you know, or go and find some random item in some random locale. Okay. And so the action just stops at that point, and they're sent out into the wider world. Okay, so we have a companion app where they literally can go and take a photo of that item, and throughout the day they can talk to the assistant and basically get clues to see where the things are. We can push them in different directions if we want to go different places, and yeah, so they literally take a photo of the item, the thing, and then we use cloud functions to, you know, fire that through cloud vision processing, work out what's in the photo, is it the right thing they've taken the photo of, how many points did they get, where they've taken the photo, so that, and then at the end of the day they come back, talk to the assistant, and it tells them the score for the day and what they could have done better, what they could have not done better, and then, you know, and then you play the game the next day.
Mm-hmm.
So you can dip in and dip out as much as you want.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the month, we calculate the kind of leaderboard for everybody. And so you're kind of gamify the whole experience.
Oh my gosh, yeah. That's such a great way to create a really interactive and fun experience for people who are new to the city.
Yeah.
Because then you could go explore and you're connecting. And then, of course, there's some people who are really competitive. So
yeah.
I could see people just wanting to do it just to win.
Exactly. So, yeah, yeah. You get some really interesting user behavior out of all this, you know. So some students were like, oh, I just want to go. For me, like exploring the city, you know, you can do the whole touristy things. But it's kind of when you go down different avenues and you kind of go and try and explore and you find different things.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but it's funny where some of the students, like, take it really too seriously. And they will actually go out and they'll be like, I'm doing this today. And I'm like, maybe you should study your homework a wee bit more.
So it sounds like you made something too amazing.
Yeah, maybe, yeah, well, I try. But yeah, so we keep it and we're basically, then. So the really interesting part of this is like, we have to get the experience right. Okay?
Exactly.
Okay, so, you know, if you come into the actual experience straight away and it's not great, okay, then you're never going to come back and use it. So we need to really, we've been really working at how to get the interaction, how to get the conversation flowing with the assistant and the user, and in that case being the student, and getting and really honing that down. So we've been really like using a kind of closed, our students as kind of guinea pigs in this, and kind of sending them out and giving them this feedback, and so they can really get it tight before we release it to the wider.
Oh, that sounds great. Do you have any learnings or findings that you've noticed when it comes to like, especially the initial first reaction or interaction with, for the user?
So getting that first experience, that getting that first part of that conversation is like the thing, you know.
That's the most important part.
Yeah, exactly. So if they don't know what they're doing, if they can't get in there quickly to get the things, then they'll just kind of like, oh, what am I doing? And then they won't come back.
Okay?
So it's kind of trying to make it fun and kind of make it engaging for them and kind of like, you know, but also here's an interesting one. Yeah. So we just, the very first iteration of this action, we had it just going, okay, go and find this, and this, and this, and this. Bye. Okay, and like, the students will come back to me and said, I can't really remember what the first two things I was supposed to go and get. So like, and we didn't have any callback to basically say, all right, you know, so we had no persistence in there. So, you know, and that was an accident by me, you know.
But that's how we learn.
Yeah, exactly. Right? And so therefore, it's like when they came back in, they would get four new random things. Yeah. And it was like, oh, okay, so what am I doing now?
Yeah.
So they were confused, okay? And so like really learning how to get that interaction properly. Okay, so do you want to know the next thing?
Yeah.
Or, you know, or just giving them two kind of sound bites, i.e. go and get a lemon or go to the Tower of London. And then, so you got that? Okay, here's the next two things.
Oh,
so yeah, so it's interesting when you actually sit down and kind of workshop this, when actually users come to use it, they throw so many different variants of things that you would never expect.
Definitely. No, that's awesome. I love the fact that you're able to connect like Google Assistant and then also with your Android app and then with photos and machine learning. Like there's so many different pieces and moving pieces.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what like, kind of makes the whole thing more fun and challenging because, you know, you have to make sure that all these bits all work at the same time to get that really big experience because you don't want that point to be like, you know, the user's waiting for things to happen and then they don't have the immediacy that the assistant actually brings to the game.
Oh, that's so awesome. Well, thank you, Steve, so much for chatting with us about this really fun game.
Yeah.
Really appreciate it. Thank you. So we hope that you liked today's show. And if you have any suggestions for future episodes, feel free to leave them as comments below. Follow us on Twitter for updates and for new episodes. I've been Jessica. Chat with you next time.